In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brother and sister, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers, and warm welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's reading. It's the 15th of August, and today we celebrate the solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And in India, we celebrate the 74th Independence Day of our country. Let's listen to the first reading taken from the book of Revelation, the last book of the Bible, chapter 11, 19th verse, then chapter 12, verses 1 to 10.
A reading from the book of Revelation. God's temple in heaven was opened, and the ark of his covenant could be seen in the temple. A great sign appeared in the sky, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was with child and wailed aloud in pain as she labored to give birth. Then another sign appeared in the sky. It was a huge red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns, and on its heads were 7 diadems. Its tail swept away a third of the stars in the sky and hurled them down to the earth. Then the dragon stood before the woman about to give birth, to devour her child when she gave birth. She gave birth to a son, a male child, destined to rule all the nations with an iron rod. Her child was caught up to God in his throne. The woman herself fled into the desert, where she had a place prepared by God. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven say, "Now have salvation and power come, and the kingdom of our God, and the authority of his anointed one." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Today, my dear friends, we celebrate the unique end of one of the most unique lives ever lived. Mary stands out among all humanity because she trusted in God wholly and completely. Even when her life and the life of her son were on the line, Mary continued to say yes to God. And as a reward for such steadfast and humble faith, the Church proclaims that she was assumed body and soul into heaven. Imagine, my dear friend, Mary's faith. It wasn't the simple, innocent faith of a young child, but the mature, reasoned faith of a woman whose mind was uncluttered by sin. When the angel Gabriel announced God's plan to her, Mary reasoned in her heart that God wouldn't ask her to do the impossible. Surely, he would protect the child in her womb. Since God himself was the author of this plan, she could trust that he would see it through to completion. This is this kind of faith that God wants each of us to imitate. Of course, none of us will ever be as perfect in following the Lord as Mary was. She was sinless after all. But at the same time, my dear friend, God does call us to try our best to follow his plans for us. And he doesn't leave us to do it all by ourselves. Every day, he is pouring out grace, helping us to say yes to him in the situations that are set before us. Every day, he offers us words of encouragement in the scriptures so that we can trust in his provision, even when logic tells us otherwise. Every day, he seeks to clothe us in his spirit so that each of us can bring Christ into the world through the witness of our own lives of faith. In the end, it is a very simple path, but one that leads to the glory of heaven. As a response to God's word, let's pray the psalm of the day. Psalm 45. Mary is associated with the queen mentioned in the psalm today. Just as the queen takes her place beside the king in majesty and splendor, so Mary is taken to heaven to share in the glory of her son Jesus. Just as the king in the psalm desires the presence of the queen at his side, so Jesus wants his mother to be with him, body and soul, in the glory of heaven. Let's pray this psalm. Today being Saturday, let's pray the Novena prayer to Our Lady of Mount Carmel.
Novena prayer to Our Lady of Mount Carmel.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Holy Mother of God, we greet you as Queen and Mother of Carmel. You were raised from being a lowly handmaid to the great dignity of the Mother of the Word Incarnate. We dedicate ourselves as an act of filial homage. We glorify the Holy Trinity by honoring you, and in our many needs, we have recourse to your protection and your powerful intercession. Jesus, your Son, was so obedient to you on earth, will certainly grant your petitions on our behalf. With this trust and unbounded confidence, we beseech you to hear our prayers and obtain for us of your divine Son the favors we request in this novena. Having experienced the efficacy of your prayers, we are full of confidence that you will gain for us this favor if it is for the glory of God and for our good. Amen. Let us pray for our petitions.
Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored thy help, and sought thine intercession was left unaided. Inspired with this confidence, I fly unto thee, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To thee I come, before thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in thy mercy, hear and answer me. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Our Lady of Mount Carmel,
pray for us.
Thanksgiving Prayer.
Holy Mother of God and Queen of Carmel, we, your children, come before you in a spirit of filial devotion and gratitude. As Mother of our spiritual life, you have obtained for us innumerable graces and blessings from our Heavenly Father, who has given to us through you the greatest of all treasures, Christ our Lord. We recognize with deep sentiments of thankfulness all the spiritual favors that have come to us through your powerful intercession. In particular, we thank you for your special protection over those who wear your holy scapular with faith and love. And finally, we thank you for answering our prayers in our personal needs. We implore from you the great grace of final perseverance, that we remain faithful to the end to your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen.
Let's pray for God's blessing. May the Lord Jesus be with you to defend you. May He be with you to sustain you. May He go before you to show you the way. May He follow you to guard you. From above, may He bless you with the Father and the Holy Spirit, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, we remember in a special way all those who are celebrating their birthday today. Anusha Melita DiMillo from Belmont, presently in Abu Dhabi. Ambrose Nazareth from Permude. Jacinta Siquera from Bendur, Mangalore. Assumpta Fernandez from Kalyanagar, Bengaluru. Wish you all a happy birthday. God bless you. We join with Lena Mendonca from Shirwan, thanking God for all the blessings received. Also, we pray for the departed soul of Sylvia DiMillo from Kuwait. May the Lord grant her eternal rest. Wish you all a happy feast of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And we, the Carmelite Fathers, greet you on the occasion of the 74th Independence Day of our country. Let's pray for our country, the citizens, the rulers, and all of us. May we all be responsible citizens of this country, imitating our Heavenly Mother's virtues. Let's be dependent on God so that we can be truly independent. Once again, wish you a happy feast and greetings of the Independence Day. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.